This is ancient Greece. How many of you have been to Greece? Raise your hand.
有去过希腊。
Okay, this is modern Greece. This is ancient Greece. This is modern Greece. Can you see big difference? Not really, right? You can see this is Athens here, and Athens now still in the same place. Okay, so there is not much change between ancient and modern Greece. Alright, so that's why the year 2004, the Olympic Games, 2004, yes, was here in Athens again, because that's where Olympic Games started. So, I just asked, this is Mount Olympus. It's not very clear because I actually took the picture somewhere at a gallery. Later on, you are going to tell me the story about Greek mythology. Okay? So, again, sorry about this is not very clear because I took the picture in the Bouffier's Gallery in Rome. Okay, and so this is the Mount Olympus. You see lots of gods and goddesses.
See the picture.
picture very clearly. It's a goddess with snake ears. So, but you also see the symbol of two serpents, right? And some of you think it's the right symbol for medicine. So what happened? This is called the caduceus. It's a short hairy stick entwined by two serpents, surmounted by wings. The stick first was born by Iris, the messenger of Hera. You know Hera, right? That's why at the beginning I told you that it's the Mount Olympus filled with gods and goddesses. Alright, so this is the Hien Hou Hera, okay, the queen of goddesses. And it was also called the wing of Hermes. Hermes, the messenger of God. Okay, so you probably know Hermes, just the because it's a brand name. Alright, so actually, this one, the wing of Hermes, it's actually for the dead. For the underworld. So that's very interesting. Because if you use two serpents, that's actually another meaning. And it's the opposite meaning. So this is actually the one serpent is from the Greek mythology. And nowadays, of course, if you know the elements, this is Hermes, the God's messenger and protector of the travelers. Alright? And then he was normally pictured with winged sandals. Alright. And so well for this that if you travel in Europe, you see some of the statues with with wings. It's actually, sometimes you think it's Cupid, but the differentiation is, there is a differentiation. Like whether only wings on the back or there are wings here, around the ears, on the heels as well. This is Hermes. Okay, so nowadays, of course, it's a very famous brand. Okay, it's a very famous French brand called Hermes. Hermes. 我们中文怎么说？很有名的，非常贵。我觉得它应该是就非常贵的一个 brand，very expensive. Which one？爱马仕。我们一个包包都五十几万，100万的。All right. So this is actually the name is from this God. All right. So why there is confusion? Why some of you think it's too certain? Some of you think, maybe one serpent. Well, there is a confusion. Alright, so the caduceus is sometimes used as a symbol for medicine, especially in North America. Okay? And there are a lot of arguments about which one should be the right symbol of medicine. But if I explain what the story what the real story is like in Greek mythology is actually very clear. It's supposed to be the wrath of God of medicine. Asclepius, right? So why there was a confusion? A 1992 survey of American Health Organization found that 62% of professional associations used the route of Asclepius, whereas in commercial organization, 76 used the caduceus. In other words, in health profession, normally they use one serpent, but if that's commercial, they use two serpents. Okay, this is a study. So if you see that, for example, this is the Association of American Medical College, one serpent, the KMU Hospital, how many serpents? What serpents? Alright, the usage is the U.S. Army Medical Corps. That's two serpents. But for a medical institution, one serpent. Alright, and the true story is actually, that's not because there's no constituents. The fact is the double serpent entwined staff with wings has a modern origin. It's the printer's mark of a popular 19th century medical publisher instead of the ancient producers of Hermes. In other words, it was the printer's mark. 就是他可能印完了，然后可能对折 they fold the paper, 然后变成 one sheet and then became two serpents. So that was actually a mistake. That's not because they used the computers as the symbol. So, anyway, that's why there was a confusion. And sometimes you think two serpents also a symbol, but normally it's used for US military.Army medical course at the beginning of the 20th century. So, the misunderstanding of ancient mythology, iconography that led to inappropriate popularization of modern caduceus as medical symbol, but actually it's supposed to be this one, Asclepius' rod. So,Well, we explain a little bit about the medical symbol. Now, we're going to talk about the basic picture of human anatomy. And first of all, we talk about atlas. All right? Do you know this word? Before. Huh? Sorry? Somebody said it? Okay, before, when we didn't have GPS,We didn't have a smartphone. There was once a time, smartphone only got popular for the past 10 years. So when I was driving, for example, in the United States, in Britain, I normally need an atlas. 就是那个很大的地图啊，一本。因为要跨州嘛，so we have to look at, we need to have an atlas.But this word is actually from Greek mythology as well. It's one of the titans. Titans, if you have not a little bit, because we can't, like, within 2 hours time, I tell you the whole book of Greek mythology. I could just tell you some, okay, related to medicine. And the Atlas is one of the titans.Titans means those who study the world, the universe, the personification of endurance. 还是指的是非常强韧的哈，非常有耐力的。He led the Titans in rebellion against Zeus and was condemned to bear heavens upon his shoulders. Alright, since at the beginning of the universe, it was actually very chaotic.And then father kills son, son kills father, and father marries daughter, so he marries brothers. We'll talk a little bit more. Okay, so, anyway, he was condemned to bear the heavens upon his shoulder. So, he was also said to have been appointed guardian of the pillars which held earth and sky.So he was actually shouldered the whole earth as a punishment and held the pillars, as the guardian of the pillars, which held earth and sky. So this is the punishment, and then this is also test his endurance. And his name is now used to describe.What? Describe? Well, just now I told you that, you know, Atlas could mean, the whole comprehensive picture of map. A comprehensive map. So this one is not used to describe. When I say map, we also say human atlases.This is human atlases. This is what you are going to struggle with this semester. And for the rest of your, I wouldn't say life,
a career. So you better remember this word. So, which one is might be called Athens? Which one might be named Athens based on the story?
Apple.
Let's study Apple. And what is the vibe?
was not invited to a party at Mount Olympics, so she was very angry about it. So if you want to really win this friendship, you just ask one question. Who is the most beautiful woman in our class? 2 most beautiful women in the class. If you're so stupid to choose one, alright, you will make the rest of the girls angry. So this is what she did. She gave a golden apple. She wanted to give the golden apple to the most beautiful goddess on Mount Olympics. So of course, these three powerful women, Athena, and Venus, and Hera, they wanted to be the most beautiful goddess. So they asked Paris, if you still remember Paris, that will actually, to some certain extent, host the world of Troy. Troy's identity is in way Paris and Kaiser, just in way Paris, in way the golden apple. So they asked Paris to be the judge, and then they gave him different prizes for being selected as the most beautiful woman. So Athena, of course, she is the goddess of the world. And she said, if you chose me, I will be the most powerful military. And Venus said, if you chose me, I give you the most beautiful woman. And Hera said, if you choose me, I give you a kingdom. So if you are a man, see, so difficult.
Thank you.
benefits, 就是这个代理是正管资本啊。 Linus, in quite a lot of galleries or museums, normally known as quite precious, that even the state, not only statue, but also paintings. So this is Aphrodite, this is Roman name, Linus, the most beautiful goddess among the great goddesses, and a symbol of beauty. And she is the daughter of Diana and Jupiter. And she actually sprang from the form of the sea at Cyprus. She actually very interesting, married to Hephaestus. 你知道 Hephaestus 吗? Alright, 他是火神. He is considered one of the arborist god. 然后你们去看一下他的. So that's why she had many affairs. 那火神 had many affairs, she had many affairs, a lot. You read all the different types of stories about Aphrodite. So this is Linus the Milo, it's Museum du Louvre in Paris. 这个是, oh, let me ask you. Museum du Louvre, 有三大镇馆之吧? The three museum treasures in Museum du Louvre. Louvre, 三大镇馆之吧? Which three? 他 Mona Lisa, the other one, Goddess of Victory, and then 再来就是他了哈, Venus the Milo. 因为大概这个很难得周边没有人, normally there is a huge crowd. Okay, so there are a lot of words from Aphrodite. She is goddess of beauty. She had many affairs. She is a symbol of beauty and love. So this word from Aphrodite. Aphrodite. What does this mean? What could this word mean? Raise your hand, extra points, come on. Something to do with the Aphrodite.
This is the heat. Minus.
English.
In Japanese, try.
Try. About?
Breast.
Sorry. You only see women's breast. Breast. It's symbolic. This is business. This is nothing else. Okay. It's a contagious. All right. Well, sexual intercourse， 而是我们说性病哈，这个是从这个它的载体 this word。 Okay， so， hymen。
Yeah. Cupid， 长大成人的 Cupid。
Something to do with the god Eros. yours and how about psyche? The girl that your classmate just mentioned about. Like psyche feel very sorry because when Eurus found psyche, tried to see his face. But it's a very complicated because the psyche is the most beautiful woman. And Psyche's sisters are very envious about Psyche as well. So they told Psyche that Cupid could be a monster. So that's why Psyche tried to see his face. So when Cupid, Eros, found this out, he told Psyche, if there is no trust, there is no If there is no trust, there is no love. So if your girlfriend, your boyfriend asks you, where did you go just now for the whole night? You can tell if there is no trust, there is no love. So, Eros fled away. Psyche feels so sorry about. And then Aphrodite, she went to Aphrodite to ask for Eros. And Aphrodite gave her lots of difficult tests. And then eventually Psyche managed to see Eros. So there are a lot of famous paintings, statues about Cupid and Psyche. This is at the Museum of the Louvre. 这也是在蒙福宫的 Cupid and Psyche. One of the days, if you visit Museum of the Louvre, 你没有去过罗浮宫的举手？ 有没有看过这个？ 还知道故事？ It says, oh, it's such a beautiful statue, Cupid and Psyche. But actually, there is a story behind. And so Psyche in Greek means soul, alright? And yeah, there's lots of word. Okay, formed from this root, psyche. So, psychology. This is in the future. Sooner or later, you're going to study this. Psychology, you have already studied this. This is the science of mind and behaviors. So later on, they are together. They got married. So normally we say a marriage is supposed to have Cupid and Psyche. What it means, marriage is supposed to, the marriage of Psyche and Cupid is love plus soul. So we say soulmate, like sometimes a person's. Alright, everybody is looking for soulmate. Because there's not only love, not only passion, but also soul. Okay, so this is Aphrodite and Eros. Okay, this the mother and son are dealing with love. And there are quite some words stem from the medical terminology stem from this to like the God. Psyche and Aphrodite and Eros. And who is this god? Ah, very good. Anybody who wants to tell a story about this god? Yuzhou, I see you for several times. Put your hand on your forehead. Means you want to rest your hand, so you try to summon enough courage to rest your hand. You want to tell us a story about this god?
Thank you.
loves himself, right?
He loves himself.
Yeah, so he is a very beautiful God, and he saw his own reflection. He falls in love with his own reflection. So he, one day he tried to impress his own image, and he then fell into the water and turned into a flower. So it's not Narcissus. Okay, 那我们后来这个 Narcissus 呢，就变成什么？ 水仙花, okay, so this is also a kind of psychological symptoms, but it's all the things that every time you just say, it's me, it's about me, the whole universe just operates around me, turns around me. We say this person is pretty much narcissistic, alright? Narcissism, or extreme self-love based on an idealized self-image. Okay, so look at this God. Also, some of Aphrodite's. It's Phorkys. Okay, and this is the story. It's a myth. Fell in love with him, tried to impress him when he plunged into the lake. He didn't like it and tried to push away. So she prayed to God to cause their bodies never to be separated, which eventually happened. 从此以后就连在一起了。所以这个字呢，就是 What does this mean? Alright, this is you will see again. 这个都是我在国外拍的哈，你都会看到他们的故事。 But if you see something like that, it's two persons that pretty much merged together. 那应该就是在讲的是这一个神神哦，Hermaphroditus. Alright, and then this is also the story about how the gods and goddesses eventually come in together. So. Anybody? Okay, it's an animal or plant having both male and female reproductive organs.